It was Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about sudden root resorption that you might get, or even just widened PDLs during treatment, or even before treatment, but we're talking more about during or after treatment. So I hope that you're taking progress panel x-rays on your patients at least every 6 months, more common or more frequently if you've got endodontically treated teeth or any teeth that are on watch. But if you start to see anything funky happening, like majorly widened PDLs, roots that are resorbing, roots, you know, lucencies at the tips, anything like that, you got to put your dental hat on and, you know, take a breath. First of all, in the informed consent, there is something that says this may happen. I'm hoping that you have the informed consent signed. There are standard informed consent for braces or appliance patients, and there's informed consent for aligner patients. You should have one. Most major aligner companies have one. I recommend also getting the regular standard ortho one signed. Get both signed, because that one's a little bit more robust and it's more likely to protect you. But just a thought. We do sell these in our document store, or if you work with us on any of your cases, be it a la carte, VIP, a concierge, a premium, whatever, or even if you take any of our digital courses, we'd be glad to give you a few documents. So just reach out to us at info@straightsmilesolutions.com. I might ask for some documentation to prove that you signed up for things, but we will give it to you. Even if you attend one of our webinars, we will give you some of the stuff, you know, in limitation. Anyways, so of course, if you get any type of funky reading, I always recommend, if you're getting it on a pano, that you verify on a PA or a CBCT, just to make sure it's not just like foreshortening or just a weird angulation or something like that, or an artifact. Always good to confirm it and get a clearer image. Remember, panos are just for screening. After that, you need to put on your general dental hat. You need to take, you know, do perio probing. You need to, if it's got braces, you have to untie the wire, check for mobility. I always recommend checking with articulating paper to see if there's contacts or heavy contacts or any contacts on those teeth that are, especially if it's front teeth, you shouldn't have them. And if it's back teeth, are they heavier than the other ones? Are they unbalanced contacts? And you know, check for vitality, endo, check for fractures. I mean, you gotta check for all that stuff. And then, you know, if something's going on, the most common thing that tends to happen is that either your forces are too heavy, especially in braces patients, you kind of burnt the roots out, or you push the teeth through the bone, either buccally, labially, usually lingually is not a thing. It's usually more out and forward that you pushed it too far forward. This can happen even with aligner patients. Most commonly it's contacts that are too heavy or where they shouldn't be. So in that case, you're gonna go ahead and take the tooth out of occlusion. You can splint the tooth. There's a lot of things you can do, or you could lock it, you know, with a retainer. Just wear a retainer full time. Make sure the patient has a few, because they're gonna have to switch them out daytime and nighttime for a few weeks, but only do that if you've taken it out of occlusion. That's really important. And then circle back to that tooth. Will a root grow back? Absolutely not, but a PDL might grow back. You know, it might, you know, solidify and the mobility might get better. Certainly if there's a perio issue, you send to a periodontist. If there's an endo issue, you send to the endodontist. If there's a fracture issue, you send to the oral surgeon. You don't continue the ortho in this situation without their written authorization to go ahead and proceed. And sometimes you have to discontinue treatment. Again, this is all covered in your informed consent. It occasionally happens. They should have written, read, and signed for it. And when you go over informed consent, you need to go over any questions that they have. You know, you let them know we're proceeding with treatment, but sometimes there's unforeseen circumstances where you have to discontinue treatment early. In those circumstances, depending on the timing of it, you may or may not need to give a partial refund. So I'm sorry if that happens. It also really depends on when it is, when it happened, how far you got in the treatment. Sometimes it's just the right thing to do. Do you have to? Always no, but you might really have a more pissed off patient. So, and then you need to come up with an aftercare program that's going to work for the patient long term. Hopefully that is helpful. And as always, you know, be careful and monitor your patients. Thanks.